Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together to welcome comedian and political activist, Terrence K. Williams.
All right, can y'all hear me now? How's it going, Atlanta? I said, how y'all doing, Atlanta? Look at all these beautiful people in the building, baby. All these black folks, it feels like a family reunion right now. Feel like, but I am talking to my family because we are family. But it's good to be in Atlanta. But I came out here, I didn't come out here to joke around and make jokes. None of that. I wanted to, but I actually wanted to come out here and share my story and let Black America know, people, period, know that the American dream is real. That you can be anybody, that you can do anything in this country that you want to do, no matter where you come from. So a lot of people ask me, Terrence, so, you know, how was your upbringing? Did you have a mother and a father? Were you in a two-parent household? And I actually grew up in foster care. My mother and my father were both addicted to drugs. My mother had 9 children, 6 different fathers, and none of them were around. And she eventually lost us in the system. She lost her rights eventually. I was in and out of shelters, homeless shelters, children's shelters, no family, separated from my siblings. I never even dreamed of being on a stage like this at all, coming from where I come from. But this is America. No matter where you come from, no matter how you are brought up, you have an opportunity. But I had many choices. I could have sold drugs. I used to be inspired to be a drug dealer. I wanted to be a thug. I wanted to gang bang. Well, first of all, I'm too small anyway, so. That's one reason why I really didn't go down that route. I'ma just be honest with you. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oops. No, but for real though, I've been in over about 10 different foster homes, and there were times I felt like I could never be anybody, that I used to be like, I don't have a chance. My mom and daddy ain't around. I'm not about to be nobody. I'm gonna just sell drugs and make money. Don't nobody love me anyway. I stayed getting in trouble because I felt like nobody loved me. I felt like I didn't have a chance. I felt like the world owed me everything. I felt like I was a victim. And a lot of people made me feel like I was a victim. Oh, Terrence, it's okay. You was in foster care. It's okay that you did that. Don't worry about it. You're in foster care. You have an excuse. But to be honest with you, there are no excuses. There are no excuses. Don't nobody owe you nothing. I don't owe you nothing. I don't owe you nothing. The white man Bob don't owe you nothing. The white lady Sally and Tammy don't owe you nothing. You know who owe you something? You owe yourself. And once I realized that, I got my head on straight. Once I realized that, but it took me a long time. It took me a very long time to realize that, that nobody owed me nothing. When I was thinking people owed me stuff, wasn't nothing coming to me. So, so I'm not gonna lie, that helped me out too. I'm like, well, maybe I gotta get it on my own. But I just really want people to know, people to understand. I go around and I talk to foster kids, to at-risk kids, to people with no mother, no father. And there are a lot of people out there that believe that because they grew up, that they believe that they grew up a certain way, that they grew up from the, that they started from the bottom, that they cannot make it to the top. And that is a lie. That is a lie. We have the same opportunities that everybody else got, okay? You just gotta get up off your butt, get up off your narrow behind, stop being lazy and take those opportunities. Start walking through those doors, okay? There are people in this world right now that grew up with a mother and a father. I grew up with no mother and no father, and I'm doing way better than them. You know why? Because this is America. You can do anything you want to do. I love y'all, Atlanta. I love y'all, Atlanta. I love y'all, and I really want the best for everybody, not just for Black America, not just for Black America, but for America, period. I want the best for everybody. Black people need to know that the American dream is true. White people need to know that the American dream is true. Hispanics, Asians, everybody. We all go through things. Everybody go through something, okay? You're not the only one struggling with something. You are not the only one. Ooh, my blood pressure. Lord Jesus, I don't know how much time I got, but I don't care no more. Candace gonna have to drag me off this stage because I'm not going nowhere. I'm feeling the spirit. And I'm done when I say I'm done. I'm playing Candace because Candace is grandpa in the building, and I'm not about to disrespect your granddaughter because she told me you don't play. So... And I want to touch on something that David Harris was talking about killing babies and killing Black babies. I've heard some people say, well, you know what, Terrence? Your mother should have aborted y'all so you didn't have to go through what you went through. People have an excuse for killing babies. Oh, if the mother is not financially stable, she should kill the babies. No. And that's why I thank my mom. Even though I went through what I went through, I still love her, and I thank her for not aborting none of my... I thank her for not aborting... She had 9 children. She did not abort none of us at all, and I thank her for that. Because you know what? We all deserve to be here no matter what. Just because your mama broke don't mean you gotta die. You want me to die because my mama can't buy no food? It's people out there that want to feed me. But you want me to die? Oh, no. No. So I am totally against aborting babies. I'm totally against, I don't care what you say, okay? Because people say I should have been aborted because my mama was not financially or mentally stable to take care of me. But guess what? I started out in the foster homes, made it all the way to the White House, baby. I said I made it to the White House. The American dream is real. Went from the foster house to the White House, baby. So you can't tell me Black people don't have opportunities in America. You can't tell me little Black boys in the hood can never be anybody. That's a dang lie because I'm somebody, baby. And what you not about to do, you not about to tell me what I should believe in and who I should believe in and who I should vote for. Oh, Lord Jesus. No, because I get pissed off when people try to control me. When people try to tell me who I should believe in, okay? I believe in what I want to believe in, okay? Because I'm a free black man in America, baby. Baby, we in Atlanta, Georgia. Martin Luther King walked these streets and protested so I could say what I want to say. Well, I ain't playing. You know what, Atlanta? I love y'all so much, it was a blessing. God bless America. You can do whatever you want to do, baby.